Alrighty, so let's go ahead and do what we all want to be done, hopefully. That is the purchase of a Dietz Miles Pantera. The 1970s was generally known as the height of the supercar boom, said nobody ever. It was during this time period that many supercars appeared on the scene. At that time, Ford Motor Company put great emphasis on the motorsport in order to improve their corporate image. To that end, Ford poured its attention on the Pantera. The scenario envisioned for the Pantera project would be one of great success due to extensive cooperation from all areas of Ford, as well as support ranging from power unit provision to extensive use of their sales network. But upon closer inspection, the supercar boom was fading due to the energy crisis. As a result, the Pantera sales flopped. In the midst of poor sales, the car was still revered and highly sought for its high performance. The engine was Ford's V8 engine. This engine was praised because, while having the performance level of a supercar, it did not have to sacrifice on production issues since it avoided the use of complicated mechanisms and the expensive materials. Scroll a little faster, please. By mounting the unit lengthwise in the midship layout and by making the overhang both in the front and rear extremely short, weight was gathered to the car's center of gravity, and thus it was a design that could achieve an ideal weight distribution. It could be said that this car has a maneuverability appropriate for a true midship sport. Yeah! And plus, I mean, it's just a freaking Di Tommaso Pantera. I mean, how can you not like it? You know, it's just one of those cars that, like, you know, just everybody likes it. You have to, otherwise you're some sort of weirdo. I mean, it's just so not right, but so right. Random license plate is random. Except for that. Yes, we do want to change that car, and let's go to the tuning shop and let's spend way too much money. Woo! $284,000! Yeah! It's an expensive 130 horsepower right there. But it'll have to do, I suppose. Get the muffler system, get the cooling system, and we've already spent, you know, $400,000 basically. Yeah. Told you there was a reason that we would be saving the money. Was not joking at all. Unfortunately, I don't think you really can do anything aerodynamically to the car, although I think you can put the rear wing on it. But we'll see about that in a moment. Although we're not going to have any money anyways. Let's see here. Let's try and find a wheel that looks appropriate to put onto a freaking Di Tommaso Pantera and amongst all these tuner style rims. Yeah, there's nothing. There's pretty much nothing that's actually going to look not like garbage. But let's try. Wheel selection is just so freaking limited. Let's try these things. What's the worst that can happen? Kinda work. Ish. Maybe. Kinda. Sorta. Hey. I think we'll go back to stock. The stock wheels that come in non-stock sizes. Yep, we are out of money. Oh, show. We are totally out of money now. But yeah, you can still carbonize all of the parts, but there's just nothing that you can do to it other than carbonize things. It's kind of a bit of a bummer. can't put the spoiler on there. Sweet GT wing there, bro. I don't think we have enough money to do it in carbon, which if you're gonna do it, you might as well do it right. I mean, and apparently that little blade right there, the top there, weighs 18 kilos. It's a pretty heavy little part. Must be made of solid lead. Change the headlights because why not? Tail lights alone because we're not an a-hole. We'll leave the blinkers alone because that's just how I'm used to them. And take the license plate off because don't want no cops pulling us over, giving us crap. And that's that. We now have a 520 horsepower Dietz Monster Pantera. Yes. So, I guess here's as good of a place to start as ever. Let's just go ahead and jump into Osaka again, only on one of the new sections. Yeah. I can just imagine some guy with like a bow and arrow shooting 9 arrows at one time. I don't know how well that's going to work out for him. I don't think it probably will. So let's see how the Pantera performs. Bullet of Nanki. And I don't like remember any of these team names, so we'll have to go through the bio and everything like that for these guys. Got new music here. I have a feeling this Dietz Masso might end up being slightly faster than the 180 was. This thing just... this thing is way faster. Also way more difficult to control, that's for sure. Hey, we got $7,000. We can maybe eventually put a carbon fiber spoiler on this thing. And we still got to do all the weight reduction and everything, so this car's only going to get faster. It just pulls, man. The power, the torque, the glory. Yes, I'm racing a blue Dietz Mazda Pantera on the Japanese highway in a Japanese game because reasons. I still don't understand it. Cyclone from Team K's. He has 0.000 chance, especially with the mufflers, bro. Wait, really? These mufflers are pretty ridiculous. How did they not, like, scrape the ground every time you go over one of the expansion joints in these highways? But I guess, you know, such technicalities are not a problem. Definitely quite sensitive to steering inputs. There was a bus there. So what we have gathered from this is never play the odds. Never play the odds. Quite clearly, even when they're in your favor, they probably aren't actually in your favor. So let's go ahead and jump up to this next guy. Another guy from Team K's, Raging Gale. Supra here. Which again, hierarchy of cars here. Dietz Masso, clearly superior. That's why I'm just going to go ahead and leave him in the dust. Sorry to all you Supra fans out there, but... Di Tommaso! And here's like the one section... This section... This is like the only part in the game where you get like down to like the city streets. And... It's just like so random. It just like happens and then all of a sudden it's like, oh crap, oh fudge, what's going on here? Which is definitely a nice, unique little section. There's nobody on our radar. We'll hit the pit area, but it's like so surprise! Which is kind of goofy. I don't know this area well at all. It's literally been years. I still remember the Tokyo Highway and everything, as well as the beginning sections and some of the extended sections, but I don't remember this section at all. But fortunately, I'm pretty sure the Pantera will bail us out here. Darkwing from Team Nightwing. Oh my god, we got toll booths! Surprise, toll booth is surprise. Toll booths are always fun in this game, though. There's a couple of them you pull through at like 215 miles an hour later on, especially in Tokyo. Those ones are kind of hanging on your butts because you either get it right or you smash into it and you come to a complete stop in an instant. So we'll just continue this gravy train. Dominating people. If it does turn out this car is a bit too overpowered, we might have to go switch to something else or bring the 180 back out, but Pantera! Alright, Crimson Wing. Team Nightwing. Driving Super RZ. Mildly customized. But again, hierarchy of cars demands that the Pantera will win. Pretty sure I've pissed off plenty of super fans already. I'm sorry. Yeah, you know, it's just how it works. I don't care if it's a freaking Mark IV Supra. You know, it's... Ah! Apparently, this car isn't actually as wide as you think it is. Although one thing about this car, it is naturally aspirated, so therefore no boosties. So we don't get to have fun with that turbo action. Although it does mean that it does tend to run a little bit cooler. It is a little bit easier to manage the temperatures because you're not using that boost. And especially this car in general anyways, I mean it is very powerful. Dark Gringling. So apparently... Team Nightwing is all named wings and based off their color, which is somewhat fitting. At least their colors are matching their names. So, done a decent job here. Developers weren't drunk the night they programmed and coded them, yeah, so it's all good. So twitchy. Definitely do not look forward to driving the tires off of this thing, that is for sure. Tight corner coming up here. Apparently he just smashed into the wall, something fierce. So when we get up here, we'll get an opponent redraw going on. We'll find somebody to race. Back for the next victim. Okay, and I think this guy's actually a wanderer, FD Tomo-san. And he's a wanderer. Definitely interesting choice of colors going on there. He's definitely got an interesting sticker. It's like a... I don't know. What even is that? Trying to trying to drive while trying to figure out that. I think that's a one-legged superhero with very large attachments, if you know what I mean. That's what I'm seeing there. I'm seeing a one-legged guy running, and he's literally got balls. He's literally got balls of steel, apparently. That's what I'm seeing, at least. Could very well be wrong, and I kind of hope I am, because that doesn't really make too much sense, but the pilot's going to spin us into the sense pits. Send us into the spin cycle. So on to the next guy, as we're back here in the same section of Osaka, but I'm trying to jump out of here and get into a different area. These guys, I don't know if we'll meet the requirements, but sometimes there's people you have to just basically smash the snot out of to get them to move again. Wanderer, Beat Ignition. Yep, so we meet the requirements. It sucks to be him. Because again, Pantera, you lose. Your argument is irrelevant, D. Tommaso Pantera. There we go, it's a puzzle. Guys definitely stick around a lot better than the first section did. Oh, again, should not have too much of a problem with them. I might have a problem with my driving there, as I almost drive right into the wall. That will do you no good. So I'm going to go ahead and take the left up here at the junction and get back to where we kind of started and continue working that area. Alrighty, Thunderclap! And a car that big should not be painted in that bright of a color. Woo! That's one way to get some attention. Drove a car like that in the real world, you'd have the cops pulling you over all the time. You know, like, you ain't gonna get out of nothing driving a car like that, man. There you go. Nice couple corners there. Taking the preferred racing line and all that, you know, clipping the apexes. Leave this guy in my dust. Again, for some reason, the menus are still totally garbled and screwed up, but whatever! I don't claim to understand these things. Gotta remember, we are getting close to that section here where we do end up on the city streets. Holy buckets. Them tires, man. Look at them tires. Them tires are so tiny. Oh, your tires, man. Oh, they're so small and cute. Oh, how adorable. And here comes freaking Pantera with meaty tires. I mean, this isn't even fair. I mean, that... Again, hierarchy of cars and, you know, all that, just clearly you just need to give me your money and that just needs to be that. And in case you were doubting me when I said there's AI catch up, whee! Ah! Wall tap. Somehow, I'm pretty sure that guy was driving his car at like 175 miles an hour. I'm pretty sure that thing should not even be capable of 175 miles an hour. Next victim. The road up here gets squigglier, apparently, according to the map. and I have not a clue where I'm going from here, so yay! Fun, fun, fun! It should be interesting. Driving a ridiculously fast car on city streets, and you don't know where they're going, and it's dark, so you can't really see all that well. Come on, here we go. I don't know where I'm going. follow the arrows. I don't know what just happened other than the fact something just happened. I don't know where I'm going, just keep following the signs and hopefully somehow you come out the other side. We're all good. Let's catch up with this blue arrow as we venture into uncharted territory here. And somewhere around here, now that we are into the second section of the game, Wangan Runner, the Wanderer. Lots of wanderers out, actually. But now that we're in the second section of the game, the special opponents will come out with the special cars, which those are the three cars in the intro movie. If you remember that, the MCR R34 GTR, the Matchless Crowd Racing, that's in Tokyo, which I remember the requirements to get that one because that car is friggin' sweet, and also a friggin' rocket ship. The West Racing Corvette, which is in Nagoya, which you need to meet certain requirements, which is 130 mile an hour battle average speed. Which fortunately, driving a car like the Pantera, you're going to get to pretty quickly. And then here in Osaka, there is the Ridox Supra. Which is conveniently the thumbnail for this series of videos. But I don't remember what the requirements are for that. Or where he races at. The other ones I know pretty much still even without having to look up to a list, but have to check for that guy. So Dynamite from Team Low Position. Yes, you are in a low position because you suck. You suck. Tires are starting to go away a bit. Not sure if I'm doing a handful, but if I'm right correctly, Team Well Positioned, their shtick is they all drive their cars lower to the maximum. Because that makes them faster. Personally, I'm on Team Driving in the Back of a Bus because that makes you not faster. Something like that. Let's just carry on, and eventually we'll get some more opponents onto the map. It is kind of janky here in this section. So, join you guys in a bit. Oh, hey! Speak of the devil, and he shall appear! Just was cruising around and all of a sudden I got challenged out of nowhere by Ordemabu, which is the Ridox Supra. So, sweet! Get in the wall! No! Don't bounce back into my way! No! Goodness, this is like the crummiest battle ever right here. Just everybody smashing into things, bouncing off of walls. This is not good. Off to a terrible start. Yeah, he's got us. Which these cars are all custom cars that come pre-tuned. You can't do anything to them. But they're basically like special edition. They're real-world cars, and they come as they are, basically. They're very fast. They're very fast. Like, the MCR R34 is ridiculous. You can see he's getting wheel spin in second gear there. If I remember correctly, though, the Supra, I never really cared for it. Like, it didn't seem as useful as the R34. For one reason or another. I want to beat him, though, why we have him out here. Where we don't have to worry about requirements and all that. Smoke him while you got him, right? So you can see, though, much more challenging. Much more challenging. Push it to the limit. Woo! Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy. With the jump pass. Now, don't bust me, bro. Don't bust me. Somehow, again, he's Mazda Pantera. Not actually as wide as you think. The more you know. He's just skating around all over there. So now, we block. And this car is all over the place. I think he might have just blown up. You can see the exhaust. Exhaust smoke, that means we're overheating. Here he comes. Yes, got him. Yeah, we overheated there. He definitely overheated. But so did he. You could tell he dropped back in an instant once he got there. So he was boosting. He was absolutely boosting. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. Hey! He's a race car driver. I'm sure some of you guys probably know that guy, because apparently that guy is supposed to be the guy from, what is it? The one Japanese show that's on, yeah, the DVDs or whatever. Strongest wanderer in the Hanshin area. He is a decent racer, and people tremble just hearing his name. He gives no credit to any racer who wins only by luck. Well, I jumped past you and beat you, so ha! I won it fair and square. I mean, surely. He demonstrates his technique and experience not only in the mountain passes but also in the city. It would not be an exaggeration to say he has artistry in his drifting skills. His settings are precise. So that's that, and let's go ahead and head on out and see where we are. Totally forgot where we went in the pit area. I don't know if we should actually do more races because this thing is starting to get a bit of a mess in terms of handling, but hey, there's the 10-10 Kaku guy that we needed to race. Although now that we have absolutely no money, although we did get a bit more money during this mega racing, so. No! 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 No, 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 no! Should've known better. Should have known better. And if we do beat this guy, his team leader's gonna come out, which that's not gonna work well. You might have been able to hear there, I was just off the throttle throughout that whole corner, just like, come on out the other side. Oh, it's an R32. That's fine though. That's fine. So I don't think we have that available for purchase yet either. More cars to purchase, the better. Let's give it a whirl here. does it? It's like, even when you counter steer, it just doesn't do anything once the tires are worn. You just keep on going whatever direction you were going. The grip is gone. That is well enough, because victory is ours. Because sometimes it's fun to live recklessly. Let's go ahead and just keep on going. Yeah, let's. What's the worst that can happen? We lose in embarrassing fashion? Let's see, what's this guy got? Safety something or other. I think this is... I can't remember the team's name. Home Run. If I remember correctly, this team is all a bunch of baseball players. Is their thing. So, I guess, you know, hey, if there's a team dedicated just to baseball players, I don't see why Michael Jordan couldn't be, you know, street racing in Tokyo. I mean, if baseball players do it, you know. Whoa, buddy! She's gone! She is gone! She just snapped. It's like, nope, not having it. Not having it at all. Oh man, that thing just in an instant, man. So we'll call it a day there. Dark Wolf. Finally got level 2 suspension. Got the GTR R32, as well as the Radoc Supra, which has 570 horsepower and unknown mass. All the boss cars are like that. Or not the boss cars, but the super custom cars. They have unknown weight, which I don't know why they did that. Doesn't seem quite right. And find it. Oh, it's in special. But yeah, they cost a pretty penny, to say the least. $768,000, that's a lot. A lot a month. And plus, you can go faster with the Pantera anyways. So, actually, I'm going to call it there. I've been recording this session as one long continuous thing here for like an hour and a half, 2 hours, which that's plenty for me. And, yeah, so hope you guys enjoyed, and roll on to the next section and all that stuff, and fun, Pantera, yeah! So, yeah, bye.